Smell that? It's time for a swing dance reaction video.
No. No. No.
Yes!
Woo! Welcome to Street Smart Swing. My name is Jamin Jackson, also known as the Galactic Swing Dance Umpire. I'm super excited to be able to take a look at another Lindy Hop video. In fact, a good friend of mine sent this over to me. It's from Lindy Hop Nonstop 2019. It's a solo jazz competition, but it's a little different. Let's get into it.
And here we go.
All right, guys, we're live. Lindy Hop Nonstop solo jazz in Krakow. I've been there. Nice place. I think I've actually... I don't know if I've danced in this venue before, but maybe. All right. Solo jazz is so hard to judge, but I'm gonna tell you guys how I look at it when this competition is over. So far, let me tell you who's on my mind right now, who I'm looking at. And it usually is the people who are not moving that much. So right now I'm looking at the girl that has the white jacket, white shirt, black pants. She's keeping it cool, and therefore she's standing out. Now granted, you can stand still and like pick your nose, and you'll stand out. Don't do that, but do something, and she's doing that. She's let me see her personality. Yeah, this is fun. This is gonna be really good. I don't know who I'm gonna pick yet. That's the thing. I'm still kind of looking and... Yeah, see, there you go. The girl that I was talking about, she's actually my favorite. She's in the finals. Whoa! Shadow Theater! Oh, this is what he meant. A good friend of mine who used to run this event is the one that sent me this video. And he mentioned this. This is cool. Yeah, what a great idea. I don't think I've ever seen a competition like this. Number two. I love this. This is different. I mean, this is part of like vintage style. This was like a big technological achievement for a theater. And people could put a spot on a screen and be enlarged and dance. And it's hard to make this look interesting. All right, who's next? Yeah. See, right now, this person is smart. They were like, well, they did this. I'm going to do this instead. So he's adding some dimension to the shadow. So he's getting bigger and smaller and playing around with his length. And I like, so far, I like him the best.
Yeah.
Yeah. Now, so I'm assuming this person's gonna do something a little different too. Yes. Yes. If it fails, just work it. Yes. That's great. All right. Ooh, this is cool. Yeah. All right, what's happening next? Oh, something slow. It's like an advertisement for vintage, like underwear, like Victoria's Secret. That's hilarious. My boy is back! There he is! Yes! It's something simple about understanding contrast.
God!
Yes! That's great! That's great. And she's growing. That was awesome. All right, what happens now? Yeah. Charleston. Thank you. Cool.
But wait, there's more.
Is this an all skate with everybody? Yeah, that's funny. Yes, yes. That's great. Yes. Great. What a great idea for the dancers. And I had a great time watching that. That was my very first time seeing a solo jazz competition that basically used spotlights and a screen and shadows. I thought that was really clever. I mean, it's really hard to keep Lindy Hop events interesting. Everyone has these formats that you have to do, and if you don't have the formats, and people won't register for your band, if you don't have all the stuff, and people get upset. And there's so much more vintage material to pull from that people just have to think a little bit harder to reach at. And I'm really happy that this event decided to even think about that type of model for your solo jazz competition. That made it even more interesting, because a lot of times solo jazz is late at night. People are like eating their late night tacos, or they want to go back to bed and get up early and go to classes. You got that group of people. But I normally don't stay up for the solo jazz competitions. And if they told me that they were going to do this, I would have been the first one there to watch it. Been the first one there to watch it. Now, I will tell you, it's tough judging solo jazz because it's very subjective. I look at the vintage qualities of the original dancers. And I compare those to the modern street dancers. And the only differentiating factor that is consistent is they don't move the upper body as much as modern dancers today. If the modern dancers today isolate their body, I can't tell if it's a solo jazz dancer or a hip-hop dancer. It's just that simple. It's just a small little portion of the body that takes the focus. And so when the dancers were dancing without the screen, my favorite dancer was the lady with the white jacket, like I said. She was appealing not just in profile, but she was appealing in depth, right? She was doing subtle things that I could only appreciate from a certain perspective. when she went into the spotlight with the sheet, it was a little different to appreciate. It was harder for me to appreciate her movements because a lot of her movements were linear facing me, right? And very few of them would create profile. So it's interesting what perspective can do with lighting. I think that's fascinating. Like, she was my favorite without the lighting. And, oh, shall I say, my favorite that a lot of people were cheering for is the gentleman with the pink jacket. I wasn't even looking at his solo jazz that much without the screen. But it was something about his dancing quality that was elaborated and highlighted more when there was a limitation on what you could actually see. I think he had the best way of moving in profile, right? To create some type of angle so I can appreciate his movements. And it's hard to dance that way if you don't know that's what makes the movement look appealing if you can only see contrast, like black and white, right? So he had some really, really funny movements. I don't even know if he intended it to be that funny because some of them were just hilarious just because it was contrasting what everybody else was doing. So there's some real depth to that. There's some real lessons that I would take from that in my own solo jazz dancing. I would test, I'd videotape myself and test to see if I could do movements like the gentleman in the pink jacket without having a screen. How could I make my movements look more appealing if someone was looking at it with profile as opposed to just straight ahead? But then I'd also think about, hey, what kind of movements can I do if I was facing the camera that will look just as appealing as the lady in the white coat? Because both of them had some tremendous qualities that were opposite when they were put in different environments. That's the principle I take away from this. That was really fun. And I think it challenged me as a dancer to go, man, could I do well behind that curtain? I don't know. I don't know. I don't know what I would do. But I certainly know I'd be aware that profile is important. And so what did you guys think about that? I heard everybody laughing in the audience. I apparently I'm not the only one that thought he was great. Let me know what you think in the comment section. Are you guys working on solo jazz? Have you ever done authentic jazz? Because there's a difference between this kind of jazz and a lot of the jazz that we hear in studios, right? Pas de bourrée, touch, jump, and no, that's not the same as authentic jazz and solo jazz. Same words, but they have different implications. So if you haven't taken any like traditional solo jazz steps, I encourage you, like a class in those steps. I would really urge you to take some class. Show up to a class physically with other people if you can. If you're a slow learner and you need some privacy, I encourage you to check out some of my courses below. I provide you guys with some of the more traditional authentic jazz classes to help you just get an understanding of the basic movement. But there are also more complicated ones that you have to learn once you kind of assimilate into the swing dancing community. Those few people who actually like swing dancing really, really well, you got to learn all these routines. You just have to know them. It's part of the legacy that you're part of, right? So with that said, guys, I thoroughly enjoyed that. Thanks, Bartosz, for sharing it. That was an amazing experience. I'm super excited to witness a competition like that for the first time. I think it's incredibly original at a swing event, and I hope they do that again next year. That was 2019, but we're in 2020 now, and I'm sure they're probably planning on next year's event, so I'm looking forward to scrutinizing that event as soon as it comes out. Anyways, guys, if I don't see you in class in one of my online classes, I will see you in the next reaction video. Have a good one. Take care.